Sentiment analysis is one of the cornerstones of social media analysis, and it is key to helping you understand your customers better. But what should you analyze to find out what your customers like? I'm Chia, and I'll be explaining this inside this video. Hey, it's Chia from Brand24, and today I want to talk about sentiment analysis and how it can help you find out just what your customers like. So, just in case anybody's wondering what is sentiment analysis in the first place, let's start by answering that question. Sentiment analysis is about taking digital texts like customer reviews, threads in discussion forums on blogs or social media, things like that, and then classifying it as positive, neutral, or negative. It's a type of emotional artificial intelligence or emotion AI, so you can also analyze other feelings like fear, joy, or love. And in terms of basic business and e-commerce needs, just finding out what your customers like, it's enough to focus on positive, neutral, and negative sentiment. So what does sentiment analysis show us exactly? Well, I mean, a lot. If you look at the context of text with positive sentiment, you can see what customers like about your product, and oftentimes, they'll also tell you how you can make it better for them, like with more sizes and colors to choose from. And feedback with negative sentiment is just as valuable. So let's say a customer has a bad experience with your service and leaves a really negative review for your company, like Mary here on Yelp, where everybody can see. Now, ideally, you're already tracking your customer reviews, so you would find out about this as soon as it was posted and deal with it before it got over 1,500 votes, seriously hurting your brand reputation. You can't always make a bad review online go away, but the key is to find it before it gets out of hand. And then you can decide how to take action, like with an apology, maybe a voucher, and in some cases, a really strong defense. Basically, sentiment analysis is exactly what you need to help you find out what your customers like and dislike. But unless you're doing general market research, then first you need to have something specific to analyze. And if you want to find out what your customers like or dislike, then that something is going to be customer feedback. So I'm going to show you four simple ways to get customer feedback, plus a couple of free tools that you can use for this. So one way to get customer feedback is by creating surveys or questionnaires. You've probably taken a survey yourself at some point. I mean, I know I have, and there's a really good chance that it was powered by SurveyMonkey. This is a great tool for creating customer surveys, and it's not the only one. There's also SurveyAnyplace, which is a similar tool for building surveys, and they also have some interactive features that you can incorporate to make your survey experience a little more interesting. So you can share surveys on your company's social media channels or embed one in a blog post. Just share it wherever you can to get as many responses as possible. And email is another way to get customer feedback. This is a pretty good one since with the right copy, you can make it feel personal even if it's an automated message and it's not very intrusive. So as long as you're not like pestering your clients with an email every single day and assuming you have a good open rate, you're not landing in too many spam folders, then your customers will see your message. And if they want to, they will respond at their own convenience. Plus, you can always stick a survey inside an email. So a third way to get customer feedback is, of course, face-to-face. Now, you may or may not have many chances for this, but if you attend a conference or host a meet and greet on a smaller scale, then you can talk to your customers in person. And if you get a good conversation going, this is a good opportunity to find out what they think about your company and your product. Now, the fourth way is, I think, the most laid-back way to get customer feedback. And this is by just monitoring online mentions of your company. So I am all about taking up as little of other people's time as possible, at least when it comes to getting customer feedback. And monitoring mentions of your brand is one way that actually requires no engagement with your customers at all. I know how this sounds, and I promise I do actually like people. But another important benefit of social media monitoring is that with some monitoring tools, sentiment analysis is automatic. Like with Brand24, not only will it collect your customer feedback from all over the internet, so that's from Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, discussion forums, review sites like TripAdvisor, or Google Reviews, Yelp, and blogs, and just a bunch of other places, Brand24 also analyzes that feedback for positive, neutral, and negative sentiment automatically. So you don't have to look for customer feedback and then manually analyze it for sentiment. You can go ahead and focus on the context of that feedback and the best ways to apply it to your brand. So this was just a general look at sentiment analysis and how it helps you find out what your customers like. But if you are really curious about sentiment analysis as a topic and you want to learn more about how it works, there is a great book that you can check out. Chris, our research and development guy at Brand 24, who is also our resident expert on sentiment analysis, recommended it to me. It's called Sentiment Analysis, Mining Opinions, Sentiments and Emotions by Professor Bing Liu of the University of Illinois at Chicago. And Professor Liu is actually one of the first people to have ever created a sentiment analysis algorithm, so it's coming straight from the source. I learned a lot from the book when I was researching the topic and found it really interesting, so you can check that out if you want to learn more about sentiment analysis. And that is it for now. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section below, or you can also give me your feedback on what you want to hear about. And if you found this video helpful, feel free to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, where I will be explaining all things related to social media and digital marketing. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something useful, and I'll see you next time. Bye.